I told you I'd ride you! Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Lest I Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I'm your host, once again, ShadowYuri333, just cleaning out the last few things. Because I never killed those crabs over there, and I never killed the sandworm. And now I have... Did I drop a miracle? Lightning stake. Strike with the stake of lightning. Ooh, a lost dragon slaying miracle. Strikes the stake of lightning. This tale describes the lost practices of ancient dragon slayers who found that in order to pierce dragon scale, lightning should not be hurled as a bolt, but rather be thrust as a stake directly into the dragon's hide to be truly effective. But that requires 35 faith, which I'm never going to have, unless I put on a faith ring. Which, I mean, I could do. Got one. Do I have one of those? Do I not have a faith plus ring? I thought I did. Oh well, guess not. That's a bit of a shame. Anyway. So yeah, at this point, I think that's it for cleanup, for stuff I haven't killed that I kind of wanted to get through killing. So that pretty much just leaves the last bit, which is putting the ashes down. I mean, I'm assuming that this is gonna be it. Like, this is... After this is the final fight. Like, once this is done, this is the end of the Let's Play. This has been interesting, I gotta say. Having never done a Let's Play before, it was definitely a novel experience, if somewhat really hard. Oh, I've got nowhere near enough souls for that. But yeah, that was it was kind of tricky and kind of annoying, I suppose. In some ways. In other ways, it was kind of fun. It was interesting. It was different. Certainly helped me, well, first off, test my microphone, just make sure that was all set up. I did get a new microphone halfway through, so I don't know if anyone noticed, but yeah. So that got tested a bit, and it also helped with... I think it might help a bit when it comes to doing other first-person video stuff and feeling more confident about doing them, because... That's something. Whatever. I can easily get these. Wait, no. I saw another one. Ashen. That's something which has always been a problem for me.
Welcome, host. Speak. Very well, then take.
So. Definitely interesting.
Farewell, Hadmi.
All right, but at any rate, looks like this is about. It is about to end. Like I said, I plan to do the DLC with this character. I don't plan to do New Game Plus until that happens. Oh yeah, I forgot to read one thing I forgot to do, actually. Before I forget and before I place it. Cinders of Lothric. Cinders of a lord left by Prince Lothric. If the lords will not return to the thrones themselves, let them return as cinders. The Lothric bloodline was obsessed with creating a worthy heir, and when this proved impossible, resorted to unspeakable means. Suffice it to say, the path to linking the fire is a cursed one indeed. Actually, you know, I kind of want to talk to all the people here one last time before I put all the cinders on.
Oh, please, the little... You know, in with a pretty hard terror...
I've learned all the miracles I really care about. Manuel died a while ago, but I'm less sad about that.
Speak freely. Oh Lord, I prithee when the other are.
Okay, nothing new. Bunch of sorceries.
Be safe.
So you have patches and it has anything to say. It looks like no one really has anything new to say because now I have all the cinders. Alright, well that doesn't really help me any. Wow. 60 episodes ago, this was a bit of a challenge. Now it's just... there. Well, for old time's sake, simple pleasures. Oh, what's this? Oh, is that Cirrus? Huh. Well. Sunless Talisman. Talisman given to the Knights of the Sunless Realms who serve the Nameless Moon. Scales with intelligence, which is rare for a miracle catalyst, but makes it compatible with dark. In the Sunless Realms, this fact is related first as an initial warning. And it's just the poise thing, as with all talismans when you use the weapon art. The Sunset Shield, Shield of the Holy Knights of the Sunless Realms, engraved with a brilliant flame crest that burns blight. Try that again. Engraved with a brilliant flame crest that burns brightly within the Order's customary sunset colors, this design symbolizes those who both harbor and oppose the power of flame. And it's a parrying shield. I gotta put that away too, because I don't really care for shields. So yeah. I guess there's really not much left. It's just... I mean, all of these... I'm not sure where these are supposed to be. I never really thought about that. Like... Yeah, they're hollows, but why are they hanging out at the Cemetery of Ash? Why are they hanging out here by Firelink Shrine? But they're not going inside or anything. They're just sort of hanging out here. Never really thought about that. It's kind of odd, though. And of course, that was the Master. Our ass, and then we killed him. Hey. Well, I guess no more delaying. Let's just finish this up.
The five lords sit their five thrones, all thanks to thee, most worthy of lords. Ashen One, with the lords as thy witness, bend thy knee afore the bonfire's coiled sword, and let the lords' embers acknowledge thee as their true heir, a true lord, fit to link the fire. Ashen One, kill I will as it. Farewell, Mace.
Oops. I wanted to leave. Unless this is just trigger the final boss fight or trigger the opening to, like, a lower area, kind of like in the first game.
Noble Lords of Cinder. The fire fades. And the lords go without thrones. Surrender your fires to the true heir. Let her grant death to the old gods of Lordran, deliverers of the first flame.
Oh. Whoa. What the heck? Oh, hey, we have another one of the Archstone warp things. Flameless Shrine. Okay, it's not the same as the area I was in before. Thought it might have been. Like the dark area after Champion Gundyr. That's what I was looking for, actually. But it doesn't look like the same thing. That one was dark. Like, completely dark. I thought, oh, maybe that's where we are. Maybe that's where we are. But no, it's not quite. Although this area's got to be explored. But yeah, clearly this is lead up to final boss fight. That's pretty obvious. And apparently I cannot explore that far. Okay. I'd like to hope I hope I don't miss anything. That's the one thing here. Looks like no, there's nothing really to miss. Everything you could go to other than just out is blocked off. Proceeded the first flame, that's what this does. So yeah, a bit of a bookend, where the first area you go to requires that you touch a bonfire and then teleport, and the last one, you touch a bonfire and then teleport. Wow. Well, Azalothra Castle apparently all messed up. Wait, is this messed up the rest of the world? Like, if I go to the High Well of Lothric or something, like, let's not be incurious here. Let's see what happens. Let's see what's going on in the rest of the world. Have I changed this guy permanently here? Everywhere? Is this place just broken now? No, still the standard eclipse. If I go to Lothric Castle, it probably would be the same thing. Yep, okay, so it's just that's a special area that's basically the end of time. And in that area, much like, I guess, the other area with Dark Firelink Shrine. Okay. Alright. Is this gonna be Gwyn again? This is gonna be Gwyn again, isn't it? No Black Knights, though. You ahead? Oh, do you fight yourself? That sounds horrible, actually. No. I thought that was a grab attack. Oh, What? Huh. It's like I'm fighting the coiled bonfire. Seriously? Oh, okay, so you can't just spam roll, and that'll do the trick. Aw, what? Seriously? This can't be it. Thank you. Storm Ruler!
Ow!
Close enough, I guess. Huh. It's over. It's all over. So is it touch the bonfire to link the fire, or touch something else to go away? Link the first flame? And there's a summon sign here. Summon Firekeeper. What happens if I leave? I can just leave. Huh. Okay. Yeah, if I want to, I can just go off and do other stuff. Well, huh. I mean, Yuria said something about trying, like, starting to link the flame, and then once you start linking the flame, I'll usurp it instead. So, no. So, I don't want to accidentally link the fire. That's the one thing.
Gracious Lord, make Lundor whole.
Thank you.
Phew. No. No New Game Plus yet. Well, that was Dark Souls 3. Welcome to the world of the new Dark Lord, Irina Pera. However, it's actually not entirely. So, it's mostly everything. However, I realized there's that bell in Arshdragon Peak I haven't rung yet. That will be our epilogue. I think this is a good place to end it off. To end off the main series. I mean, if there's anything after that bell, well, that'll be in the epilogue, but Soul of Cinder is dead. Irina Pera is the new Dark Lord of Londor. What happened to Yuria? Given the way Londorians tend to go, she's probably dead. Oh no, she's still alive. Hey.
Ah, our lord and liege. Thine heart is fixed upon the linking of the fire. But brave usurper, so that we hollows.
But I
our lord, I prithee when the moment, the age of fire, but the gods are lord. Honorable usurper, so that...
I did, but okay, I guess you didn't notice. But yeah. Seriously? Like, if I go here, it'll ask me... Yeah. Oh, that's dangerously close to begin journey two. Well, anyway.
Ashen one, thou wishest yet for a world without fire. For an end to the linking of the fire. Then call upon me. I am a firekeeper, and I tend the flame to the very end. Thou hast given me eyes, and such it was they showed me. Ashen one, if he hazard, mayst thou...
That's odd. I'm curious if anything's changed with the kiln itself. But if there's nothing changed here, then... Because people are acting like I actually haven't done anything. I just became the Dark Lord of Londor. It'd be nice if someone acknowledged that. So let's talk about that boss. That was a pretty cool boss. Except for that one really heavy multi-swipe attack, which, granted, was always following a jump attack. The only reason I was able to actually do anything is that after every jump attack, there's that other attack. Oh, it's still... Oh no, it's gone. I've usurped the fire. Hooray! But yeah, every single time in the second phase, the boss would jump. The first time they jump, they'd always follow up with that really heavy multi-slash attack, which was the only way I could get around it. It's essentially, oh, they're jumping at me, get away! Especially if they're looking like they're gonna charge up, get the hell away! And then that way I was able to survive. But man, that was frustrating. Every other part of it, I kind of got, once I just got enough attack power to power through it and stagger the bloody... Soul of Cinder, but yeah, otherwise, no. Also, we do have a procedure. As always, I haven't forgotten. This will be possibly the last, maybe the second last, depending on what we do in the epilogue. Soul of the Lords. Soul of the Lords, one of the twisted souls, steeped in strength. Used to acquire numerous souls or transpose to extract its true strength. Since Lord Gwyn, the first Lord of Cinder, many exalted lords have linked the first flame, and it is their very souls that have manifested themselves as defender of the flame. Which I think it's all the more appropriate that I've become the Dark Lord. Having taken that flame, you're guarding it for a good reason. Anyhow, I also want to see what I can transpose it into. Oh yeah, I guess Lilith kind of burned up when I linked the fire enough to get to the kiln of the first flame. Anyway, first off is Sunlight Spear. Miracle of Gwyn, the First Lord, hurls a Sunlight Spear. The tales of Gwyn's Archdragon hunts describe the inception of the Age of Fire, where he used a bunch of Sunlight Spears. And the Firelink Greatsword, the Lords of Cinder linked the first flame, and this greatsword was wielded by their Deific manifestation. This coiled sword, found thrust in the bonfire, existed long before the throneless lords themselves. Skill is ember, and flame momentarily illuminates and launches itself forward. I'm unable to wield this. Well, actually, there's a ring I can put on that'll allow me to wield it. Well, I mean, we already read what the soul had. I'm curious how many souls that soul goes for before I use it. I'm thinking, might as well use it on that sword. I'm curious what it has. But, I mean, if I'm going to steal the fire, I better steal the whole thing. What is the... 20k.
Ashen.
I know it sounds weird, but level 116. I can go to the Archdragon Peak and get 20k souls in 2 minutes. Give me that sword. Let's try this thing out. All right. We have the Scholar Ring. There we go. That's what I need. Firelink Greatsword. Wow, what was that? 25? Oh, no. FP cost is 25. Oh, that's pretty good stats. So, it's overhead swing and strong attack. Overhead and two-handed weak. Swipe and two-handed strong. Rolling one-handed overhead. Rolling two-handed is a big swipe. Rolling two-handed weak is overhead. Rolling two-handed strong is the same thing. So rolling attacks don't change strong. Jumping attack is standard overhead. Two-handed jumping attack, same thing. And skill. I got my beam! Wow, I pulled out the Excalibur reference way too early, but oh well. Yes, I wear my inspirations on my sleeve. Anyhow. I'm pretty happy with having grabbed this. I mean, at this point I need a ring to wield it, but I'm okay with that. I mean, the Untrue Dark Ring isn't gonna be on there in New Game Plus, so this should be interesting. Alright, well, that is that. I will ring the bell in the next episode, the last episode, the truly last episode, but this is the Beat the Game episode. So, until the very last one, until DLC, I bid you farewell, and thank you for watching.